hey, if you're a scientist and watching this, make an artificial intellect, stop now. Didn't Tony Stark teach you something?
Hi guys, it's Christina, and I'm basically here to tell you my impression about the movie, and I also sound like Ultron. So I finally seen the Avengers 2. So the movie was amazing, even though I personally think that Loki was more elegant as a villain, in my humble opinion. And it has nothing to do with the fact that my dog's name is Loki, and I also wrote my year paper on Loki, and I'm not obsessed, I promise. So yeah, if you haven't seen the Avengers 2 Age of Ultron, you should definitely go check it out. And if you haven't seen the Avengers, the first Avengers, I'm not even taking it. You're in denial. So actually, I'm a long time just Whedon fan, and I also a huge sucker for good like fantasy and science fiction. I love science fiction. And I also was in love with just Whedon ever since Buffy hit the TV. By the time I was like 5 or 6 years old. So I think that like more younger generation than I am, or in my generation, is more obsessed with stuff like Twilight, which is like in my book. I mean, people, have you seen the way Whedon portrayed the vampires? And they don't sparkle. That was supposed to be a horrifying thing, a vampire. And now it falls in love, sparkles, and makes kids like, the hell, people! So yeah, I actually made a list of 5 just Whedon written movies that you might want to check out if you like The Avengers. Of course, it didn't include in this list stuff like The Avengers or Buffy or Angel, because I feel like everybody knows this stuff. But if you didn't check the last one out, do yourself a favor, stop watching my stupid face and go watch some David Boreanaz, like. Let's jump into it, come on. So yeah, thing number one on my list is The Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., which isn't actually a movie, it's a TV show. It was created and in some part written by Joss Whedon. Spoiler alert, Phil Coulson didn't die in First Avengers. And apparently now he has a group of Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. and we as an audience can get acquainted with the what life and work of S.H.I.E.L.D. actually is like. It's fun. Movie number two is Serenity, which is a movie made of a TV show with the same name. It actually reminds me of Fifth Element at some point. It is a story of a spaceship and a crew on that spaceship and how they cruise through space. I said space too many times. And also, I cannot advertise movies. Damn it. Number three is actually The Cabin in the Woods, which is a horror movie, and it's really fascinating. Chris Hemsworth is there. Tom Hiddleston loved the movie. Guys, the movie was approved by Loki himself. Need I say more? Movie number four! This time, the number's correct. The movie is called In Your Eyes, and it's actually one of the newest of Whedon's films, and it's like a fun turn to romantic movies or romantic comedies in general with a big story. It's how souls are connected. Forget those damn 50 Shades of Grey. It's actually a story about two people's minds getting connected, which is like really smart. And it also shows to you that it's okay to talk to yourself if you are in Joss Whedon movie. Movie number five, The Atlantis. Both of them, actually. Do you remember how awesome it was back in the day? Like finding that unknown country, unknown land with this crazy technology. You remember? You were there. we're kids together. So just grab yourself, I also said grab yourself some porn. So just grab yourself some popcorn and let's rewatch it together. Because it's awesome.